discussed the some recording ta ekhane hocche na actually that's why not recording ta discuss the some problems on boiler. Instead of that, very important chapter, let me start. If after that I get some time, I will start that problem solution of boiler. There is a gas turbine. So we'll discuss today. Now, what is the purpose of the gas turbine? Gas turbine generally uses aircraft. We are using the gas turbine. What is the purpose of the gas turbine? Do they produce power? Now, aircraft which is flying very high altitudes. For that aircraft size has to be, for aircraft power size, this power plant size has to be small. We cannot build boiler, we cannot build turbine, steam turbine. So huge foundations, all these things, huge layout is required for that. It is steam thermal power plant. For aircraft which is flying at a very high altitudes, for providing the power to the aircraft, for propelling it, I need gas turbine. Why? Because gas turbine size is small. This is the advantage. Size is small. Now, also, it has weight is small, weight is less, bulky. Because in the aircraft, weight is important. Always we give the priority in the less weight. Less weight is the important because there is a weight is the concern for an aircraft. So, gas turbine has a some. Weight is less, and another advantage in the gas turbine is that is, so if in the steam thermal power plant it takes 4 to 5 hours from starting, and then we are getting the load. Suppose we start the steam plant, we start here, and after we get the load, that means we found the generations. So it takes at least 4 to 5 hours. But here in gas turbine power plant, within 30 minutes, half an hour. 30 minutes, gas turbine started, and within 30 minutes I get the power. So that is the advantage. So if we do it in very short, within a very short span of time, we get the power. So that is the advantage of gas turbine. Now, another thing is that any type of fuel can be burned. So that is the advantage of gas turbine. It has some disadvantage also that we will discuss later. So what is the gas turbine's layout? Let me discuss. What are the components in the gas turbines? In the gas turbine, there is one compressor is there. So this is compressor. It takes air. So this is the compressor. It takes air from the atmosphere it takes the air, and then this air goes to combustion chamber. This is the combustion chamber, CC, combustion chamber. So in the combustion chamber, this air goes. So air is going, and we are giving the fuel also. Here we are giving the fuel. What is the fuel? Aviation fuel. That is the kerosene type fuels we are giving. So here from we are giving the air, and we are spraying the fuel. So air of fuel and igniting. So if we ignite it, some gas will be produced. So that gas we are calling it a flue gas. So that gas we are giving it to a turbine. So this turbine is called gas turbine, GT. And after that, gas. So in the gas turbine, what is there? In the gas turbines, there is a blades are there, like steam turbines. And there is one GT is there. There is the generator. And generator produces the power. And after that flue gas expanded in the gas turbine, it goes out and goes to atmosphere. So that means, so what are the components are there? So one compressor is there. So this is the compressor. This part is the compressor. This part is the combustion chamber, and this is the gas turbine. Gas turbine. Now, so three components are there. There is no condenser. In this case, no condenser is there. So this acts as a boiler, and this acts as a pump, and this is the gas turbine. So this type of cycle is called open cycle. Why open cycle? This type of cycle is called open cycle. Why? Because we are taking the air and we are compressing it. Then we are giving the combustion chamber. We are firing with the fuel. Then flue gas is produced that goes inside the gas turbine. In the steam turbine, who goes? Steam goes. In the gas turbine, who goes? Gas goes. Heated gas, high temperature gases goes inside the gas turbine. So that gas produces the work, and that is going to the atmosphere. So continuously aircraft is taking air from the high altitude, they are taking air from the atmosphere and they are discharging to the atmosphere. So the air is abundantly available there. So there is no problem, there is no requirement of recycling it. So we are taking air and that air. So this type of cycle is called open cycle. Now, if suppose this cycle I have to recycle, then there is a, that cycle is called closed cycle. So this again cools in some heat exchangers. So this is that I'll show you in the different layout. So what is happening here? Gas turbine produces work, but the compressor I need. To run the compressor, I need the power. Then who will run the compressor? Because for running the compressor, for running the pump, I need the power. Who will provide? Here, the gas turbine, who produces the power, it is coupled. That means as soon as the gas turbine produces the power, it will supply the gas turbine to the compressor. So they are connected to the same shaft. There is a same shaft. This is the shaft. Come same shaft. Shaft is connected. As soon as the gas turbine starts rotating, compressor will also start rotating. So they are coupled. So here, what is the disadvantage? First disadvantage is in gas turbine that first take of this disadvantage is that it takes, suppose gas turbine produces 100 megawatt. So gas turbine 100 megawatt, two third. What is the two third? Two-third of 100 megawatt, nearly 67 megawatt. So this compressor, this consumes 67 megawatt. So out of 100 megawatt, it takes 67 megawatt. Okay. Then what is left? 33 megawatt. 33 megawatt. Then 33 megawatt is left. Then this generator produces 33 megawatt. That means it supplies. So generator produces 33 megawatt. This is the net output. What is the net output then? W net is equal to W turbine minus W compressor. So 100 minus 67. So ultimately we are getting. So I am, though gas turbine is producing 100 megawatt, but finally we are getting 33 megawatt, which is very less. So that is why, it is less, because the consumption of this compressor is very high. So that's why there is the main disadvantage. However, due to some other advantages that we are using the gas turbine in the aircraft. Now, gas turbine, let us see what is the open cycle. Open cycle we have seen. Let us see what is the closed cycle. In the closed cycle, let me clear it. So now I'll see the closed cycle. In the closed cycle, so combustion chamber is there. So this is the CC. I am writing the CC. CC means combustion chamber. So we are putting another heat exchangers here. There are four components. Earlier it was three component. So compressor was there. So this is my compressor, and this is my gas turbine. So air goes, air comes out from the heat exchangers through the tubes. So here tubes are there. Tubes are there through the tubes. Through the tubes, air flows. Now you can see. So here. So here is the working medium. What happens? Air comes out from the this is the heat exchangers. Air comes out from the heat exchangers. It goes inside the compressors. The compressor raises the pressure. It goes to the combustion chamber, but there is no direct contact. So it flows through the tubes. And in the combustion chamber, this air gets heated up, and this heated air goes inside the gas turbine GT. So here, instead of gases, heated air, hot air or heated air comes inside the gas turbine. Similarly, after it does, so through this circuit, there is a some, this working medium is air. Then how we are firing air? We are giving the additional fire, additional air. So this is the combustion air, and we are giving the fuel, and also we are giving the fuel. So this is the fuel. Fuel, and this is the air. So this is the secondary air and this is the fuel. So this produces gases here. This produces gases here, and these gases through the chimney goes out.